HTTP with persistent and non-persistent TCP connections. In the last video, we discussed HTTP messages in detail. We explored the concept that a web page can contain text, images, audio, or video, collectively referred to as objects. To display web pages on the computer screen, the web browser asks for objects from the web server using HTTP request messages. The web server sends the requested objects through HTTP response messages. In our example, the initial object sent to the web browser is an HTML text file. This information is encapsulated within the HTTP response message. The HTML file contains text and addresses or URLs for the remaining 10 images, all of which are stored on the same server. Once your web browser reads the HTML file, it asks the web server for the other 10 images over the existing TCP connection or via 10 distinct TCP connections. When the existing TCP connection is used to fetch 10 images, it is called a persistent connection. When 10 distinct TCP connections are used, it is called non-persistent connection. Let us now discuss HTTP with persistent and non-persistent connections. If we are developing an application that utilizes internet and we choose to use TCP for its transport layer services, then we have to decide whether each request response pair should be sent over separate TCP connections or if all requests and their responses should be sent over one TCP connection. The first method is called a non-persistent connection, and the second method is called a persistent connection. Consider a web page consisting of one HTML file and 10 images present on the same server. This means that there are 11 objects on the web page. Suppose this is the URL for the HTML file. The web page or 11 objects will be transferred to the web browser via TCP connections. To set up a TCP connection, the web browser sends a small TCP segment to the web server. The web server acknowledges and sends a small TCP segment back to the web browser. The web browser then sends an acknowledgement along with the HTTP request message into the TCP connection via its socket. The request message includes the path name for the HTML file. The web server receives the HTTP request message via its socket, collects the object from the measured path, and sends it in an HTTP response message. In case of non-persistent TCP connections, the web browser tells the web server to close the TCP connection after sending the response using the header line "connection closed". So, after sending the response, the web server tells TCP to close the TCP connection. But since TCP provides a reliable data transfer service, TCP does not terminate the connection until the web browser has received the HTTP response message correctly. When the web browser receives the HTTP response message, the TCP connection is closed. Hence, in a non-persistent connection, the TCP connection is closed after one request response cycle is completed. HTTP response message tells that the data it has is an HTML file. The web browser extracts the HTML file and reads it. The HTML file has URLs for 10 images. Since this is a non-persistent connection, so 10 distinct TCP connections are set up for requesting 10 images. However, in persistent TCP connections, the web server keeps the TCP connection open after sharing the HTML file. Since 10 images lie on the same server, they are received from the web server over the same TCP connection. There is no need to open 10 separate TCP connections. The web server closes the TCP connection after a configurable timeout interval. In our example, the web page consists of 11 objects, one HTML file, and 10 images. So, In a non-persistent TCP connection, 11 separate TCP connections should be opened. Therefore, 11 TCP connections are required to obtain 11 objects of the web page. On the other hand, in a persistent TCP connection, only one TCP connection is required to obtain 11 objects from the web server. Let us calculate the time required for data exchange in persistent and non-persistent TCP connections. Let us consider the user clicks on a hyperlink. This initiates a TCP connection between the web browser and the web server. The web browser sends a small TCP segment to the web server. The web server acknowledges and sends a small TCP segment back to the web browser. The web browser then sends an acknowledgement along with the HTTP request message into the TCP connection. The web server then sends the HTML file into the TCP connection. The time taken by a small packet to travel from the client to the server and then back to the client is called round trip time or RTT. So, in this example, the total response time to obtain the HTML file is 2 RTT plus transmission time at the web server. The HTML file received is pointing to 10 images on the same server. Let us assume that there are no parallel TCP connections. Therefore, in a non-persistent TCP connection, this process is repeated for each image because separate TCP connection is required for each image. Therefore, total RTT required to receive 10 images is 2 RTT multiplied by 10, which is 20 RTT. In persistent TCP connections, the images are shared over the existing TCP connection. So, only this part is repeated 10 times. Therefore, total RTT required to receive 10 images is 1 RTT multiplied by 10, which is 10 RTT. In both connections, 2 RTT is consumed to receive the first object, which is an HTML file. So, total RTT consumed to receive 11 objects in a non-persistent and persistent connection is 22 RTT and 12 RTT. So, the total delay is less in persistent TCP connections. This is one of the benefits of persistent TCP connection over non-persistent TCP connection. By default, HTTP uses persistent connections. However, the client and server can be configured to use non-persistent connections for HTTP. So in this video, we learned HTTP with persistent and non-persistent TCP connections. Thanks for watching.